Aman Sinha, spokesperson of the Bharatiya Janata Party, is very patiently waiting with us. Aman, my question to you is, the early trends are in. If you look at the trends of Rajasthan, Mizoram, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, they are very close calls, you know. You just can't call out the election. Yes, Rajasthan, Congress is leading. In Telangana, the lead is obviously with TRS. And in Mizoram, it's MNF and BJP has opened the count. So your first comments on the projected leads.
Karthike, we have been all along holding that these are close contest elections, and especially in three states of Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. And I believe these are only the postal ballots which are opening. They are very early trends. And therefore, to draw any blanket conclusions out of these trends may not be very desirable and advisable. However, what is apparent and clear is that in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan, there is going to be contest down to the wire. And let me also mention, Karthike, that the results are going to come in a little later, because in the new counting process, after every election, after every round of counting, the returning officer has to file a report or get it validated from the election commission. So results will come in a little slow, since these are close contest elections. The seats are bound to change hands, and therefore one cannot draw blanket conclusions out of this. However, what is clear is that there is going to be anti-Congress government, non-Congress government in Telangana and Mizoram, and Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh are close contest elections. We'll have to wait for the final results, because the picture will be clear only around 12 noon or so.
Aman, why did these elections became so close? Because my question to you is, not only BJP had three big faces, all of them associated with senior leaders like Vajpayee and L.K. Advani. Vasundhara was actually Prime Minister of State under Vajpayee in PMO. Congress had no leadership in Chhattisgarh. Congress is a fractured house in Madhya Pradesh. And Congress is again a fractured house in Rajasthan. But still seems to have given a fight to Bharatiya Janata Party, which is far more organized and had been rebel-free, actually.
Karthike, as you know, that there has been a drought as far as Congress Party is concerned for past 15 years in states of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. And in Rajasthan, there's been a pattern. Every 5 years, the state dispensation has been changing. So therefore, for us to have government for past 15 years, that was also a remarkable achievement. And then on back of that, Karthike, you would also, because you were there on ground reporting and you have covered so many elections, you would also acknowledge, and maybe my panelists, co-panelists would also acknowledge, that there was no perceivable anti-incumbency against our governments, either in Madhya Pradesh or in Chhattisgarh, despite 15 years of rule. That itself is a remarkable achievement. And obviously, after 15 years of rule, Karthike, there is bound to be some amount of fatigue factor or some resentment against local candidates, etc. However, the fact of the matter is that we are still very much in contest. We are perhaps front runners even now in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. And we are hoping that we will end up on the winning side.
But Aman, in case, if these are early leads, you are saying that these are early leads, and later, you know, the EVMs from other parts would be open. But right now, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, and Rajasthan are all showing Congress leads. Aman,
it might be. Therefore, I am saying, Karthike, that perhaps I doubt whether these are even EVMs in that manner or first round counts. These are merely postal ballots, and obviously postal ballots from all the constituencies, all the initial trends which come in, Karthike, they would essentially be postal ballots. So therefore, to draw any blanket conclusions out of this may not be the advisable thing to do. And as I was mentioning to you, Karthike, that the counting process is likely to be a little slower per se, because election commission would, the state election commission has to be given a contest elections, which is there in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan. You are right that maybe Congress is in the lead as per the trends which are being shown on Wion right now. But we hope and we are fully confident that by the time final results come in, we'll have an edge. We'll have a majority in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan, all three states.
Do you think, Aman, that assembly elections can actually gauge national mood? Can we call them semi-final? Or you want to limit the assembly elections to what they are?
Karthikeya, you've been covering assembly elections and Lok Sabha elections for more than past two decades, and you know, our all panelists also know that they are different ballgame altogether. However, there is one very clear trend which is there is that in Lok Sabha elections, the BJP tends to do much better than in assembly elections. For instance, even in these states, Karthikeya, in Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Rajasthan, the BJP, despite it won in 2013, but we always polled about 10% more vote share than what we used to poll in assembly elections. So therefore, I do not think that this is going to have much of an impact, regardless of the result, because BJP is clearly on a very strong wicket, a much stronger wicket relatively when it comes to Lok Sabha elections.
Thank
and
you,
the electoral evidence also reflects so.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Aman, for joining me from BJP headquarters. Thank you so much.